Okay, welcome to part three of Charlie's Gist edition. Be sure to check out part one and two. We talked about do women prefer big cocks? We talked about tea rooms and back rooms, and we just got done talking about something. I forgot already. Touching and holding. And now we're going to talk about uniforms. And you guys know that gay or straight, uniforms can be a hot thing. You know, women who might be dressed up as nurses and nurses' outfits, guys, hot men who are dressed up as cops, firemen, army, just whatever. People do have fetishes for uniforms, and it can be a big turn-on. So, let's see what the flawless book, the Joy of Gay Sex, has to say about uniforms. If you've ever been struck by a particularly sexy highway patrolman, or the smoke-blackened face of a fireman, or a hunky drill sergeant marine, you already know how much what a man is wearing can increase his allure. That's especially true if he has on clothing not found in anyone else's wardrobe, and even more if what he's wearing stands for masculinity in action, heroism, or authority. Many gay men are naturally drawn to good-looking men in uniform because of the extra machoism to be found in the image of a soldier or sailor or police officer, with its promise of free-flying testosterone and the sexual pleasures to be received from such a surfeit of hormones. But it's also true that some gay men get off on other uniforms, not usually thought of as particularly macho. Some guys go for the bus driver look, especially if he's wearing a uniform of Trailways or Greyhound bus driver, while others drool over chefs, or go ape for doctors in surgery or emergency-related clothing like loose-fitting scrubs. Train conductors and auto or airport garage mechanics' garb can also be turns-ons. For a few, the outfit worn by your plumber or the man who checks your electric meter can also be sexy. Obviously, what's going on here, like much of our sexuality, which is centered in our mind first, then in our body, is more than meets the eye. Besides the evident turn-on due to clothing, other, less apparent turn-ons are happening in the subconscious or unconscious, and sometimes it's fully conscious. The trick who arrives with the yellow construction or Con Edison helmet is telling you, "This is my fantasy today. Help me play it out." With the increase in casual wear at the workplace among men, some guys have discovered that they are turned on by what few of us consider an erotic, or in fact any kind of uniform. The stockbroker, banker, yuppie executive look, complete with shining black Johnson and Murphy wingtip shoes, clock socks, and a double strip tie. As you can see, anything that can be worn can be erotic sized enough to be a uniform. Even so, they are the old favorites: policeman, fireman, soldier. And whenever gay men's uniform parties are given, they are the ones that dominate and thrill. For some guys, there's an extra charge to getting screwed by a highway patrolman with his tight leather boots and jugglers on, while for others, the idea of thanking a brave firefighter from a position on his knees, mouth wide open, is the ultimate sexual high. Scenes involving men in uniform make some of the best play acting, porn videos, and masturbation fantasies. And what we would be truly humiliating is upsetting in real life for many gay men, being forced to suck off a cop or risk being thrown in jail, takes on a much lighter hearted, scintillating color when it happens at a sex party or at home. Some bars, clubs, and restaurants either cater to guys in uniform or have regular uniform nights. If you're interested in seeing how this clothing on a gay man affects you, take a look. It's a lot safer and easier than trying it with a man whose sexuality you do not know and with whom you may end up in trouble. Many couples participate in uniform sex, whether they're into S&M or vanilla. And once again, if you don't know the terms S&M and vanilla, go back in my videos and check out that topic. You'll find out right away. Usually one of the two is the cop or marine sergeant in full regalia, while the other member of the couple wears civvies or a less full version of the outfit. One reason for the discrepancy is that inadequately an agreed-upon power differential is needed in any such encounter. It's the essence of the sexual charge. Of course, another reason that a good, full, real-looking uniform can be pricey. Buying one at your local gay leather store or a pleasure chest could set you back several hundred dollars. On the other hand, many gays can find discounted prices on the same items if they can locate a clothing shop next to their city's or state's policemen's, firemen's, or service members' training center. These shops furnish men in uniform for a living and will have the most authentic gear. The staff will also show you how to wear it properly. Be advised, however, that in many countries, municipalities, and states, you cannot wear a weapon of any kind with the uniform, as that constitutes impersonating an officer, a serious misdemeanor, or even a felony. Also keep in mind that parading around the streets in the military or the police department uniform, even without a weapon, on any day other than Halloween can constitute a crime. Get local ordinances on the matter. So there we go, ladies and gentlemen. That was tonight's Hot Topics of the Joy of Gay Sex series. So be sure to comment. Let me know what you guys think. Any topics you want to see, go back on the show and be sure to check those out. Alrighty, and I will definitely talk to you guys soon. As you know, I'm starting to come close to the end of this Joy of Sex series, and I'm going to definitely be starting something new coming up soon, so definitely stay tuned for that. Alrighty, so thank you guys for watching tonight, and I will definitely talk to you soon. How about that?